It is time for Hoda and Jenna's relationship dilemmas.
Okay, if you want to spend the cooler fall months cuddling with someone special, we've got some help. Three-day rule matchmaker and dating coach Devyn Simone. She's here to answer all of our viewers' questions, which, thank goodness, we need you.
I know. Whenever you come, people have tons to ask. Should we get started?
Yes, let's do it. Okay, first up, we have Megan from St. Louis. Let's hear what she has to say.
How do you know if what someone is sharing, either in conversation or via a profile on a dating app or website, is authentic and truthful? Sometimes it seems like it can be a little too good to be true.
Yeah,
how to spot a
phony.
Yes.
I mean, catfishing is a real thing.
Catfishing is a real thing. So is hatfishing, but that's a different topic.
What's hatfishing?
Oh my God, it's when they wear hats all the time, so you think they have hair and they don't. You know, okay. That's a great question, Meg. Yeah. And the reality is you don't know when they're telling the truth or not, which is why it's important to take your time, because most things reveal themselves in time.
Yeah.
So don't rush it. Also, you can do basic math. So 1 + 1 should always equal 2. If
right.
they say they run several companies, but they're home messaging you online all day,
yeah.
every day, they
yeah.
probably don't have a job.
Yes.
Like, just look
do
for
a
the
little,
basic.
A little detective work.
Yes. Listen to your gut,
yes.
too, right?
Yes. Yes. All right.
To your gut.
I've got Denzel from Teaneck, New Jersey. Let's hear Denzel's situation.
So I'm currently in a relationship, and we text as soon as we wake up. We say, good morning, how are you doing? How'd you sleep? What are you having for breakfast? So my question was, is that oversharing and is that going to become a problem in the future?
Denzel, that's so cute.
That is not oversharing, Denzel.
Say good morning.
Oversharing, good morning, and
no,
what are you eating?
For breakfast?
Yes,
that's lovely.
I agree. That's so cute. Oversharing, one, doesn't really apply when you're in a relationship. It's
yeah.
sort of when
yeah.
you're on like a first date or something and you're
yeah.
telling your whole life story.
Yeah,
that's a little
that.
Much. But that's really cute. That's good communication. And you're just setting like, what is relationship but sharing experiences and moments
totally.
Together? So I think that's really
and
cute.
As long as it's mutual. Because if you're like, how are
yes,
you?
Right.
Good morning. I love you. How was your breakfast? And you get that good eggs.
Yeah. It's not reciprocal.
Not good.
Then they might not be that into you.
Okay. You really should be a relationship coach. Okay.
Really?
Up.
I don't
we
think
have
so.
Sarah from Charlotte. She has a question.
What are your thoughts on a female pursuing an obvious connection? And is it a turn on or a turn off for a man if a female is the one pursuing that initial connection?
Okay, so what do you think?
It's 2022. Pursue.
Yes!
Pursue it. But don't be overbearing about it. Like, you could say something cute and simple like, hey, is it just me or is this a thing? Like, I know you think I'm cute, but how cute do you think I am? You can do it
oh, that's
playfully.
Yeah.
And then if they're like, yeah, I think you're great, but I'm seeing someone,
yeah.
I'm talking to someone, it's really easy breezy. Don't start calling them every day
no.
or you
I
know, asking about
you.
Your meal.
Yeah.
You're okay.
Yeah,
it's
that's
a,
weird.
I think it's when it turns to needy.
Yes.
Where it's a turnoff on and any
Absolutely.
Relationship.
What if you don't, you know how you're that banter you just said,
yeah.
like, hey, I know I'm cute. Do you think I'm cute? Like, what if you don't have that? What if you're not good at that game? As a person,
by the way, you're good at that game.
No, but what if that's not your thing?
If that's not your thing, call the three of us. We'll help
okay.
you.
All right. Okay.
Or ask a friend who maybe be who
but
might be a little
you
bit
just
better.
Just also say
just
like,
say, look, I'm not. This is not my deal.
You
but
can say,
yeah.
this is not my thing.
Yeah.
But that's why you can just say, is this a thing? Right. That's
yeah.
just simple. Like, is it just me?
Thing?
Is
or,
it just me? Or is
wait,
there something here?
I had it, somebody tell me that if you feel it's a thing, it's always a thing.
That's
no,
that
no,
is not true.
That is not true. You know, I'll tell you who told
true.
Me that. Our guru told me that if
really?
You feel a spark, there's something chemical.
On your side.
Yeah,
right.
but that, like, what, you're just making up that the person's
no,
flirting with you?
No, you feel it.
Well, that's true. There
our
is a spark, but maybe
that?
It's not lit.
Well,
yeah.
it must
guru.
Be true.
Our
All right.
guru said that.
All right, we got one more. We want to hear from Allie from Charlotte. Here's her question.
So I've been in a relationship for 6 years, and I know marriage is in the cards for us. As a matter of fact, I know he's already asked my dad for his permission for my hand, but all my friends are having families now, and I'm getting really antsy, so should I give him an ultimatum?
No.
Ultimatums are not great.
No.
And especially, girl, he's almost there. Give him a minute.
Yeah.
Give him a minute. It sounds
she gave
like
him 6 years worth of minutes.
Okay.
I would say a lot of minutes.
I would say that's a lot of minutes, but if he's asked her dad for her hand in marriage, well, then clearly what? He's like moving.
No, maybe he's just slow motion in everything.
But I agree. I agree, because you're like at the finish line.
Right.
You don't want to trip him before he gets there.
Don't do that. But all your life, you are going to be waiting for things.
Well, you don't know.
That's a pattern.
Well, she already committed to that. She committed to that.
I asked your dad, and I'm still asked.
I mean, listen. Henry and I were together. They might be young. Henry and I were together 5 years.
No, but I think after you ask the dad, you need to step on it. I don't think you ask the dad, and then
she didn't say how long.
Well,
she's waiting for the ring.
Okay, listen. I agree, but maybe he didn't think the dad was going to tell her because listen.
That's what
my dad and
why did the dad tell?
Devyn and I are going to go into business together.
Kooky. All right. If you have a relationship dilemma you need help solving, send us a video. Tell us all about it. Hodaandjenna.com, and then just hit the connect button.